So any questions? I think so somebody was trying to speak. Shivam is speaking. Yes, Shivam ji.
I want to ask some.
Yeah, please, please. Yes, Shivam ji. Bataiye. Yes, Shivam. Please.
I want to ask question.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. I want to ask. Hello.
Please, please. Yes. Shivam ji, boliye.
Yes, sir. For a beginner of this, like we are involving in a spiritual world.
Yes. Shivam, can you write?
For a beginner. This journey in just like a family, but in a family, we do what like a what is facing some problem and he's facing some injuries and he's seeing some quarreling in their resources.
So Shivam, can you please write down your question
in their houses? So what should we do?
Okay, so Shivam, like what I understood is that you want to ask there is some problem or miseries in families. So what we can do for them, this is what the question is or something else. It is better that you write down because your voice is not audible. Shivam, you please write down your question. It is a network problem is there, so please write down your question. So by the time Shivam is writing the question, others can ask the question or they can also write down the so they can also write down the question there. Somebody whose connection is very fine, he can ask directly. Yes, Vipul ji, puchhiye. Vipul Kumar, do you want to ask something?
No, Prabhu.
Okay, fine. Any more questions or is it only Shivam has a question? Anybody else with questions? As we are beginner in this journey, then someday or every day we are seeing some problem or quarreling with family member. So what should we do So like I said, Shivam, that we need to practice this ABCD formula very nicely. Like we discussed, yatha tor mool nischanena triptyanti yat skandh bhujo pishakha pranopaharak yathet indriyanam sarvahanam achyutecha. So even if we want to do good for the whole society or for some particular section of the society or even for ourselves, the best remedy is that we need to practice this ABCD formula very nicely. So try to associate with simple-minded people wherever possible. Chant your rounds very, very attentively as much as possible. Try to read Bhagavad Gita Bhagavatam daily. Try to engage in some service of the Lord. And pray to the Lord that, my dear Lord, please help my family members or whomever is there who are quarreling to give out all their misconceptions and misgivings. If you understand, the root cause of all the even quarreling is what? Lust, anger, greed, pride, illusion, and envy. So if we can help them to get out of these problems, so the only cure is spiritual life. But we need not tell them that you please practice spiritual life at this stage at least. So first we need to practice very nicely. And when we are very convinced and we are very strong in our practice, then we should help others to practice spiritual life very nicely. The only cure of all these quarrels is spiritual life. And this is what best we can do is we practice ourselves very nicely. As we said, charity begins at home. So first we need to practice very nicely. And when we will practice very nicely, we will surely help others also to practice nicely. So right now, whatever system you get, try to talk to your mentors that what you can do. So try to chant your rounds. I hope that you're chanting some rounds. And I hope that you can increase those rounds, chanting of those rounds, and try to increase your attention in this chanting. And try to read books, Prabhupada books every day, something at least for 5 minutes, 15 minutes. And surely Krishna will surely help. Shivam, does it answer your question? Karna bahut bada nahi kuch karna. ABCD formula ko hi apply karna hai life mein.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anybody else? So I think so, Chirag sir, I think so, we are done with all the questions. I think so, we can end.
Hello, sir.
Mayank Piridarshan, yes. Sir, as God has created male and female in order to continue future generation and also given us family to live together, as it is law of nature, then why some saintly person goes away from family to practice God consciousness? Okay. So, Mayank Piridarshan is asking that if Lord has only given us this facility for male and female, so why does many people go out of their family to practice? So we need to understand Bhagavad Gita in this regard. So Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, fourth chapter, he will speak, Chatur Varnamaya Shrishtam Guna Karma Vibhagasha. He says that he has only made four ashrams and four varnas, so everyone can uplift them in the spiritual consciousness. So what are the four varnas? One is Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. And what are the four ashrams? Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanprastha, and Sannyas. So generally in Vedic times, till from 5 years to 25 years, a person who lived in a Gurukul and was trained personally under a bona fide spiritual master. From 25 to 50, he used to live a married life. From 50 to 75, he used to live a retired life or a vanprastha life, where he used to start detaching from the family responsibilities. And from 75 to 100, he would take a sannyas and preach Krishna consciousness. So this was the order that was designed by the Supreme Lord. So Lord has designed a male and female for the progeny, yes, to produce good God conscious or Krishna conscious children. Krishna will speak in Bhagavad Gita, that he is that desires by which good population is generated. So, although it's Lord's arrangement that he has made such events, but the Lord has also designed the other ashrams by which a person has to gradually purify him and reach to the higher conclusion. So now, there comes an option. A person who is living as a brahmachari till 25 years, he lived as a strict brahmachari life. Now he has an option. If he wants to enter grihastha life, he can enter grihastha life. If he does not want to enter grihastha life, he may remain as a brahmachari. So there are many nastic brahmacharis also. But either you live as a nastic brahmachari or you live as a grihastha, after 50 or 55 years, you have to retire from that life. You have to start retiring from your entanglements from the system. That is why the concept of retirement came up. So here you can understand that people go away from the family after fulfilling all the responsibilities they had for the family. Till the point, yes, I would like to add in here, till the point you have some many major responsibilities, a person should not go to the forest house. This is not at all accepted by the Lord in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita, 6th chapter, first number verse, Krishna will talk of the definition of renunciation. There Krishna will say two things about renunciation. He will say, first of all, you have to do those activities which are prescribed by for you. Secondly, you have to give the results of those activities to Krishna. That is real renunciation. Nor he who lights no fires and performs no duty. So a person has to understand that he has to get detached, and for to help him to get detached, a person has to enter into a phase of vanaprastha life. Now, if he very nicely follows the principles of grihastha life and very nicely follows the principles of brahmachari life, it is sure that by the end of his 50 to 55 years, he will retire from his family life. The grihastha ashram and brahmachari ashram are so designed in that way that they will help a person to retire and devote 100% exclusive time to Krishna. So we need an exclusive time to practice devotional service in this human form of life. That is our main goal. So for that, so living in a family is not denied, but to live in a family the way Krishna wants us to live. And if you live that way, that the way Krishna wants you to live in, it is sure that after 55 years, you will surely retire from family. It will be a natural outcome. It will be by a default outcome if you've lived your life as per the principles of Bhagavad Gita. So if husband and wife unite as per the principles contained in Bhagavad Gita, then surely after their retirement, they can very easily practice God consciousness. So, grihastha life is also an institution made by Krishna himself, and a vanaprastha institution is also made by Krishna himself. Both are important at a particular time. So, we need not run away from our responsibilities of grihastha ashram. But it should not be that we are too attached in family life that we don't take the vanaprastha ashram. So, both of it has to be balanced out. So Priya, so Mayankji, does it answer your question? But they did not know, so how should handle this type of people? These people with family or other depend. Now, one minute. Achha, ek dusra question bhi aa gaya. One minute, Mayankji. First, Mayankji, does it answer your question? Gautam Buddha left his family just after having a marriage and having a child. Was it correct? I don't know much about Gautam Buddha's history, but what I've heard was Gautam Buddha took permission from his wife and family members before he left. Gautam Buddha's wife gave him the permission. Yashodhara, I've heard, but I don't know much in detail. I will surely read an authentic book and get back to you that why he left and left here. But yes, he heard or he consulted his wife and he handled the responsibility very nicely and then he left. So if wife and children and agreed that they can live without the husband or without the father because he wants to go for a spiritual quest, then it is fine. Nowadays times, sir, many say this devotee's topic of fourth state of his this is a life. But I know where the devotee of the Lord is not a topic of sudden after time. For this practicing is more important because I am with this organization. But they did not know. So how should handle this type of people? These people may be a family member, other dependent. Shivam, sorry, I'm not able to understand what you want to ask. This devotee is a topic of the fourth state of his life. What do you mean by this statement?
Means, sir, brahmacharya at the time of old age.
At time of old age, he has to be sannyasi.
Yes, so sir. Means after cultivating old age of life and after when we are old, then we can start the worshipping of God at our old age.
Why
time.
Should we practice devotional service in the young, in the youth? We should practice in old age. This is the question. बचपन में भक्ति करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है, भक्ति तो बूढ़ों का काम है, ये क्वेश्चन है आपका
क्या सर? वॉइस क्लियर नहीं आई, अगेन प्लीज रिपीट।
मैं कह रहा था आपका क्वेश्चन ये है क्या कि भक्ति तो बूढ़ों का काम है, बुढ़ापे का काम है, बचपन में नहीं करना चाहिए, ये क्वेश्चन है आपका?
यस सर, यस सर। सर ऐसा कई लोग मतलब बिकॉज़ ऑफ फैमिली या मेनी पीपल्स आर सेइंग दिस
दिस ये वैसा कह रहे होंगे ना। तो आप देखिए, सबसे पहली बात आपको समझनी है, आपको भक्ति की कोई भी एक्टिविटी घर वालों के सामने नहीं करनी है। नहीं करने का मतलब है कि करनी है बट दिखावा नहीं करना है कि हम भक्ति कर रहे हैं। हमें भक्ति इस प्रकार से करनी चाहिए किसी को पता ही ना चले कि हम भक्ति कर रहे हैं। पहला तो ये करना है। तो हमें जब हमें ऐसा लगे कि हमारे तो हमें भक्ति का प्रैक्टिस करनी चाहिए, जब बहुत बहुत से लोगों को उड़ना नहीं चाहिए, कह रहे अरे तो भक्ति करने लगे, भक्ति करने लगे, भक्ति करने, वो बहुत डेंजरस है हमारे लिए। सेकेंडली, हमें मन ही मन में विश्वास होना चाहिए कि भक्ति तो केवल बचपन में ही हो सकती है, बूढ़े में भक्ति हो ही नहीं सकती। आप जरा सोचिए शिवम जी, आप अभी कौन से ईयर में है? विच ईयर?
फर्स्ट ईयर
में। अभी आप देखिए, अभी आपके पास केवल और केवल अपनी ही रिक्वायरमेंट्स को पूरा करना है। जैसे आपको अपनी पढ़ाई करनी है, आपको आपको केवल पढ़ाई करनी है, आपको घर वाले खाना देते हैं, आपके कपड़े घर वाले धोते हैं, आपकी सारी जिम्मेवारी कौन उठाते हैं? घर वाले। आपको तो केवल पढ़ाई करनी है ना, और तो कुछ नहीं करना, घर के काम तो नहीं करने रहते आपको?
Yes, sir. Sometimes,
थोड़े बहुत रहते हैं, obviously बात,
yes, थोड़े बहुत mostly study work, but sometimes we are...
हाँ, so कुछ study रहता है ना। तो अभी आपके पास कोई family responsibility तो नहीं है ना कि अरे अरे उस बुआ को ये देना है, उनको ये देना है, वो रिश्तेदार को वो करना है, उसको ये करना है, वो करना है, ऐसा responsibility भी नहीं है, कोई फैमिली वाले करते हैं। तो सोच के देखिए, जब मेरे ऊपर कोई रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है, तो मुझे मेरा जब करने को समय नहीं मिलता, रूपा जी के ग्रंथ पढ़ने का समय नहीं मिलता, भक्तों का संग करने में मुश्किल आती है, स्टिल मुझे टाइम का बड़ा क्रंच मिलता है। तो जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा, जब मेरी शादी हो जाएगी, दो बच्चे हो जाएंगे, मेरे मेरे घर वालों की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मेरे पे आ जाएगी, मेरे रिश्तेदारों की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मेरे पे आ जाएगी, तो क्या मैं भक्ति कर पाऊंगा? अभी इतना फ्री टाइम होते हुए मैं भक्ति नहीं कर सकता, तो जब मेरे पास इतनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आएगी तो क्या मैं भक्ति कर पाऊंगा? सेकेंडली, जब मैं बूढ़ा हो जाऊंगा तो बॉडी में कितने पेन होते हैं, देखिए जस्ट सी एनी ओल्ड मैन, कभी उसका हाथ दुखता है, कभी उसका पैर दुखता है, कभी उसका सर दुखता है, कभी उसका शुगर लेवल बहुत बढ़ जाता है, कभी उसका पेट खराब रहता है, तो क्या वो भक्ति ढंग से भक्ति प्रैक्टिस कर सकता है? तो कोई भी चीज जो इम्पोर्टेंट होती है वो हम बचपन से करने लग जाते हैं, अपने जो जो भी आपने आईटीजी जो भी तैयारी की होगी किसी भी एग्जाम के लिए, अपने यूथ में तैयारी की, बूढ़े होके हम कुछ नहीं सीखते, ये तो फेमस सेइंग है, जो हम 5 साल में सीखे वो सीख गए, बाकी बूढ़े होके बहुत कम सीखते हैं, पॉसिबल? तो हम शादी बूढ़े पे क्यों नहीं करते, शादी हम बचपन में क्यों करते हैं, क्योंकि हमारे पास यूथ में एनर्जी होती है, हम एक संबंध को एस्टैब्लिश कर सकते हैं इजिली, बुढ़ापे में जाके आप क्या संबंध एस्टैब्लिश करेंगे भगवान के साथ? तो प्रहलाद महाराज तो बोलते हैं कुमारम आचरित प्राज्ञो, तो जो भक्ति है वो तो 5 साल की उम्र से शुरू कर देनी चाहिए, तो जो हमें भक्ति है वो बचपन से ही शुरू करनी चाहिए, बूढ़े होके शुरू नहीं करनी चाहिए। तो बाय हार्ट वी शुड बी कन्विंस्ड कि अगर भक्ति करनी है तो यही, अब रादर बहुत लेट हो चुके हैं, प्रहलाद महाराज के स्टैंडर्ड से तो 5 साल से शुरू करनी चाहिए, अभी तो 18 साल के हो चुके हैं, 13 साल हमने भक्ति नहीं की, और जब प्राइम यूथ था जिसमें हम बहुत सारी चीजें सीख सकते थे उसमें हमने बहुत अलग अलग गलत गलत चीजें सीख ली, इसलिए अभी हमें बड़ी तीव्रता से भक्ति को लेना है, तीव्रता से ABCD फॉर्मूला को लेना है, ठीक है? Shivam, are you getting my voice? Shivam?
Sir, you can continue. I think he might not be there.
Okay, so I don't think so. I have answered his question.
No problem.
Okay. So anybody else? Shivam, if you don't understand, you can call us. We will do a one-to-one meeting and discuss your question. Anybody else? Anybody else would want to ask something? I think so, Chiragsi. I think so. We should wind up. What do you say?
Sahil sir,
Hanji, yes.
I think nobody has questions now. Yes, anybody yes, of yes. you has questions? Okay, I think nobody has questions. So we'll like to thank Sahil sir. Actually, I really troubled him yesterday. I just out of nowhere I dropped a bomb on his head that tomorrow you have to give one session. Is already so packed in his schedules. As I mentioned to you in the starting, he is already working in a, he is like already owning a company and running it also, Garg and Associates. So he's busy into that also. But still, you took out time, sir, and prepared the slides and gave such a wonderful session. Very, very grateful. Thank you so much. And we will all request you that you can some other time also, you know, in future, take this trouble of coming and addressing.
Sure. It was a great pleasure to be with all of you. So thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so I'm leaving. Thank you.